Yes.
Hello! Isn't this a fine morning?
Thank you.
I know you're feeling pretty uncomfortable right now. Don't move too much or fight it. That'll just make it worse. Can't say it's a pleasure, officer. I was really hoping not to make your acquaintance. But here we are. I'm using a pale latitude compressor. You and your partner have been caught in its field. That boy's really gonna learn to keep his trap shut. And it's not a bloody pale emitter. It doesn't emit pale.
Right behind you, officer.
A pale latitude compressor is used to sort of make the pale more manageable. With a lot of these, you can force a radio signal grid on the pale, literally crunch the distance across it. Signals are relayed across a series of repeater stations fixed to buoys. Not a fun job manning those stations. All alone out there in the pale. People lose their minds in just a few years.
So, what we are experiencing is a concentration of radio waves.
Precisely. This is an industrial strength paraboloid. It's meant for forcing dimensions on something that doesn't have them. Needless to say, the frequencies used are out of this world. At the upper limit is the large prime number generator station. It's used specifically for pale latitude compression. That's why you might be hearing some numbers. But you might also hear, or think you're hearing, local radio chatter. I built it myself.
That's illegal. I'm guessing it's patented. But we are beyond that, aren't we?
Oh yeah, way beyond. The pale? It's the end of the world. No. Once I shut down the compressor, the pain will end. It may take a few minutes for you to steady yourself, though. It's a bit like walking out of a very confusing dream. Yeah, I stuck my head in there before using it on you. Seemed like the ethical thing to do. Can't say that I enjoyed it. The field was weaker, but I can imagine what you're going through. Yeah, let's not talk about that shit. You were hunting me and fell into my trap instead. That's all there is to say about it. If you've got something really important to say, you can do it through the white noise.
Damn this!
God damn it! Fine. If you really want to talk, I can dial it down. I've also got a gun, by the way.
I'm all out of shit to give, Loincloth. Welcome to the fucking reckoning.
Put your goddamn gun down. People are gonna get hurt. We need to talk this through, all right?
Shut up! You're not gonna talk yourself out of this, Loincloth shit fuck.
Shh.
This is a misunderstanding. Nothing irreversible has happened yet. You can just return to your unit and forget all about this.
The Kift is merciful. Willing to spare us if we just forget about our murdered and humiliated commander. I think we should just kill everyone, Courtney.
You all drunk. Come to your senses. You won't gun down 7 people in the middle of the street. This isn't a frontier town or a jungle outpost.
Easy, Lizzie. Let me handle it. I know guys like this. I'm sure we can come to a peaceful agreement. Ain't that right, fella?
Peaceful? Nest in your abdominal cavity like a little wild mouse.
Fuck, there's a third one. How did we miss something like this? The mercenary tribunal. My plan is not to get killed, but we have to intervene. If this turns into a firefight, we should take him out first.
Get lost, comedian! You cops had your chance! Now it's fucking time for some justice!
Pig fuck!
We're gonna tear right through you! I don't give a shit if you're cops!
No one is going to kill anyone. Let's just put the guns down and talk like civilized human beings.
This is death. One more door, baby. One more door. Of course. I know you do. Everybody leaves when they get the chance. Go on, keep falling. Deeper. Take the door.
He's not taking it. His body is not taking it. Oh, God, no. He's not disintegrating. He's swelling up instead. Over the hours, hurting, moaning in his sleep, and rotting, and being disinfected, and smelling of drugs, and feeling saliva in his mouth, drifting in painkillers, thrashing in his wound sleep. Hours turn to days. Soon we will get up again and go through it again, again. Finally we know what the infernal engine was outside. The clarion core. It was him. He is the infernal engine. He never stops. He only gets worse.
crazy motherfucker. Didn't think it. There I was, thinking, where are we going to find a tin opener large enough for those cans? Then Copo Loco shows up and just sets a man on fire. Impressive shit, Copper. None of us would be breathing right now if it wasn't for... I guess what I'm trying to say here is thank you.
Oh, you're up. It's good to see you back on your feet. Did you like your room? I cleaned it for you.
Officer, care to play a game with a lonely old man?
Actually, never mind. It wouldn't be the same.
Officer, what happened? You're limping. Why are you limping? You look terrible. Is this from the shooting in town? We heard gunshots. Not that we don't hear gunshots all the time, but they were closer than usual.
There was an exchange of fire on the Rue de Saint-Guilaine. It's nothing to be worried about, madame.
Well, good for you. So you're a killer. That's good, I guess. I guess. Better than I. I've always taken you for one. That's for sure. Not a lot of RCM men who aren't killers. Of course. Can I help you with something?
Hey. I'm doing really good, actually. Both professionally and romantically. I've come to a fulfilling and peaceful period in my life. How are you doing, Harry? Well, I'm in my head too. We're all in our heads. Sometimes. Not as often as I used to. So much time has passed. More than it seems here. I'm going to Morova. To live there. In Grad. It's 1,000,000 kilometers away, Harry. Might as well be another lifetime. Just my scepter. My globe crucigere. A spare silk gown. A toothbrush. Travel documents. The crown of immortality. Oh, this. This is just a wreath. The crown of immortality is made of rarefied light, mana, and raw palladium. It was passed on to me by the rulers of late antiquity. Anyway. No, Harry. No. I don't want a massive epic showdown. I want to go to the aerodrome. I have tickets for the 10:20 flight to Morova. Really. We don't have anything to talk about anymore. Every combination of words has been played out. The atoms don't form us anymore. Us, our love, our unborn daughters. It's all gone. I have to go to the aerodrome. I have to leave Revachol and you. And you have to be alone. In hell. Forever. That's just the way it is.
Yes? Thank you.
what now? I may have. All sorts of little rats have come sniffing around trying to give up the position. Fire guy, regressive bourgeoisie henchman, can't even talk like a grown-up. My eyesight, yes, helps me see all this shit. I did. I should have burned that console down. Reactionary rock and roll music, playing on the water.
Told you we shouldn't play sad FM. I did.
Sad FM, huh? I always hated that station. Phlegmatic counter-revolutionary dirges. Sadness is a mental illness. A weapon of the bourgeoisie. The fascists were right about rock and roll. It is degenerate. Hip-gyrating mental illness music. You're a glorified night watchman. This is a service rifle. I can only lay it down before an enemy commander of corresponding rank. A big-time operator of the pederast army. How about I keep it, huh? Hand it over to a real killer. A briscade.
Put it down now, sir.
Or you're going to blow my brains out before you question me. To hell with it. It's a walking stick anyway. It's out of bullets.
Thank you. Thank you.
What is it? What do you want from me? I can't go.
You're quite the tide brought in. I want to call you a teapot, but I'm honestly kind of impressed. No idea where you got all that gear, but there's no doubt in my mind that some bad, bad people are looking for it. Also, you look like a fucking idiot. Oh, really? They don't seem bothered by it? That's because you're a cop in an exoskeleton. Actually, are you? Are you still a cop? There's so much disco going on, it's hard to tell.
Vic, calm down.
We are not forgetting about anything. That's right. And you're some kind of murder machine.
Hello, I'm Trent Heidelstam. I believe we've met on several occasions.
I'm your goddamn partner, Jean-Vic Mar, and this is your special task force, or what's left of it. Special Consultant Trent Heidelstam, Patrol Officer Judith Minow.
Hi.
We have come to scrape what's left of you off the pavement.
Lieutenant Kim Kitsuragi, Precinct 57. We've just come from the island where our investigation led us. We might need your help with something later. But this is clearly a departmental matter. So I'm going to leave you to discuss it among yourselves.
It's good to meet you, Lieutenant Kitsuragi. Harry, we want to help you. Trant, I believe this is where you come in?
I don't quite know what I'm doing here. I was asked to participate as an expert. I think I need to manage your expectations a little. I'm at best an enthusiast in cognitive science. My background is in something else entirely. I engage in neurology, on a merely theoretical level. In fact, I should probably get going.
No, Trant, it's too late. You're part of this shit now. What have you got to say for yourself, shit kid?